Hi, everyone. Let's dive into how you can use the ID Protection reports for managing identity compromise in your organization. Let's get started with the dashboard. Megan, can you walk us through it?
Sure. On the ID Protection dashboard, you have a snapshot of trends in your tenant, an overview of the types of attacks your tenant is facing, and some recommendations on how to improve your security posture. Starting with our trend panels, you will see the number of attacks blocked, the number of users protected, the mean time to remediate user risk, and the number of high-risk users in your environment. Each of these panels gives you a link to further investigate in their respective blades. As you use and enable ID Protection in your tenant, you should see these trend lines improved as you protect more users and remediate risks faster. Next, our attack graphic shows the effectiveness of your sign-in risk policies by highlighting the methods attackers are using to compromise accounts in your environment and where your policies are disrupting their attempts. These categories are mapped to their corresponding MITRE attack techniques. Click on each of the links for more information on their mapping. Sign-ins on the right, shown as blocked, were interrupted by one or more conditional access policies. Sign-ins marked as not remediated were not interrupted and require further action. For those, you should determine if you have a gap in an existing conditional access policy. The interactive map shows the geographic location of the risky sign-ins in your tenant. You can adjust the filters and hover over the bubbles for more information on attack volume. If you see risk activity coming from a country your company does not operate in, you may want to start there for your next investigation and considering blocking that location in conditional access. And finally, the recommendations and recent activity cards help you stay on top of what is happening in your environment. Clicking View All on Recent Activity will highlight events, both good and bad, that are notable when it comes to the security of your organization. Recommendations are tailored to your environment and are one of the best places to start when looking to improve your security posture.
That is a whole lot of goodness packed into one page, Megan. Let's dig into some of this data in our reporting blades. Now, these blades catalog the risk Microsoft has detected and let you deep dive into the details of why these accounts are risky. By sorting and filtering on risk level, risk state, and detection type, you can understand potential intrusions into your organization. Let's start by taking a look at the risky users report. Right now, I want to investigate users that are at high risk. By changing the filters, my list is automatically updated. I want to know why this user is risky. By clicking on their name, I can navigate the tabs to see basic information about the user: recent risky sign-ins, detections not related to a sign-in, and their risk and remediation history. To speed things up, organizations with Copilot for Security can use Copilot for a condensed summary on why ID Protection flagged the user for risk. For this user, I can reset their password, confirm the user as compromised or safe, dismiss the user risk, or block them. Confirming users as compromised or safe will help train our machine learning models, or ML, that determine the risk of a user. If a user has a risk detection signing in from an unfamiliar location, but I know they recently moved to a new worksite, I can mark them as safe, and our ML will begin to recognize that location as familiar. Conversely, you can mark a user as compromised, and we will automatically move the user to high risk. Your feedback on whether a user is safe or compromised helps us optimize similar detections in the future for your users, increasing precision of the detections and reducing false positives.
Well, that's great for account level risk, but what about sign-in risk?
Why don't you walk us through risky sign-ins?
Okay. The risky sign-ins report works in a very similar way to risky users, with a few key differences. Just like the risky users report, I can filter and sort the list to focus on what I want to investigate. On this report, I have a few extra filters I didn't have on the risky users report, like filtering based on real-time or aggregate risk level, sign-in type, and others, like location, device browser, or whether conditional access was applied or not. After selecting a sign-in, I have a bunch of information I can comb through in an investigation. I can see detailed device information, what the user was trying to access, and what conditional access policies were applied to the sign-in. In the Risk Info tab, I can see why ID Protection flagged the sign-in as risky. Here, I see all of the detections that were triggered on the sign-in and can expand each one to learn more information. For an even deeper view and to see how this risky sign-in is related to other types of risk in your environment, we link to Microsoft Defender. Just like for risky users, I can confirm a sign-in as safe or compromised to help fine-tune Microsoft's machine learning for my users. The final report we will go over today is our Risky Workload Identities Report, where you can learn about what service principles or applications in your environment have a risk detection associated with them. Like our other reports, you can sort and filter on various properties to target your investigation. For each risky workload identity, you can view information about the workload identity and the detections it has, as well as mark the workload identity as compromised or safe.
Nice. But let's say our team uses another tool for security incidents. Can I get this data into their tool?
Of course. You can export all of our data using diagnostic settings. Just navigate to that blade and click Add Diagnostic Setting. Then select which events you want to export. Risky users, user risk events, which are risk detections, risky service principles, or service principal risk events, which are service principal risk detections. And of course, you can use the Microsoft Graph to get all the same information. Our risk reporting is available to you through whatever channel you need.